Real quick. Let me check out these trailers. Thanks for flexing. Flexing what? Warm air, bro? Like what? Love? Lover? Stalker? Killer?
No matter how well you hit it off with somebody on the dating site, you don't really know who they are.
Damn, bro. Yo, how many people use the dating site? Yikes. I'm not gonna lie, bro. Like, if you're in school or if you, like, work, like, well, maybe I guess you wouldn't want to date somebody from work, but if you're in school, why the fuck are you on a dating site, bro? I'm sorry. Explain that to me.
This was one of the strangest, most unpredictable cases I'd ever worked.
Prosecutors allege a love triangle turned fatal.
I was starting over as a single person. And I was determined to enjoy it.
Is this real or I think this is like a, is this a documentary?
When Cherry Farber came into my life, our first date, I had made it clear I was absolutely not going to be tied down. She says, Lord, this is just fun. And I was like, oh my God, yes, I'm in. I hopped back online. That's when Liz came into my life. She was very smiley, energetic. She liked motorcycles. I had a motorcycle. I was match made in heaven. And then one morning, I get a text from Cherry Farber.
You've ruined my life.
It was a total shock. The messages.
I never want to see you again.
But it ran.
Your life will be ruined. I can see you at work. I'm watching you. You will pay.
Nobody will.
I was on a road to having a mental breakdown.
I thought I'd seen it all. I hadn't seen anything like this.
Then things got worse.
This is now a complete different investigation.
I was terrified.
I've got to catch this person.
Lock that bitch up.
I can't find her. I was trying to find a pattern in the chaos.
I found something that was missed by the original investigators.
The case took a 180 just like that.
Yeah, I'm not going to lie. Good luck dating. Good luck dating nowadays because people like, I don't want to just say women, like probably like dudes too, but I feel like women, like especially they just not the same, man. That's not the same, man. I feel like there's like high expectations. They have high expectations from like every man that they talk to. Like y'all seen the video of the girl that was like not like was refusing to get out the car because the guy took her to Cracker Barrel. Come on, bro. Was it Cracker Barrel? Cracker Barrel or some shit, man.
It was hard to know what was real.
Cheesecake. That's what it was. Cheesecake Factory, bro.
Real and what I might be imagining.
At this point, the stakes were high.
Who knows what they're capable of?
Bro, the worst saying I've ever heard is when people be like, yo, what do you bring to the table? And then girls was like, I am the table. It's like, yo, okay, it's cooked. Everything is cooked, bro.
911, what's your emergency?
I've been shot.
Good. Like, was that her that got shot? Not gonna lie. Seems like you were asking for it, bro. Seems like you were asking for it, buddy. Not gonna lie. All right, let's bro, how many like why do they drop trailers and they be like official trailer, but like this is like the 8th trailer I've seen from Tekken. It says official launch trailer. I there's already been a like an official trailer, I thought. Am I tripping? Oh my God, Rai, son of Rome.
The King of Iron Fist Tournament の開催を宣言する。ただし、力を示せぬ弱者を国ごと消えてもらうことになる。
We must seek Jin Kazama.
The battle to decide the ranks of the new world begins now!
This is the story chat.
I was born for this. You look like Vader the mix. I get a load of this. You ain't posing no threat, and now it's obvious. After rocking a gold, I'm not anonymous.
The fighters will battle for personal glory.
Y'all remember when Mortal Kombat had used 21 for their song trailer?
And the fate of their
that
countries.
Shit was kind of hard. I ain't gonna lie.
Give Kazuya a nice smack in the face.
Ah, shit. Oh, here we go. What the hell? Okay, that's cool. Lose yourself to the music. What the fuck? This shit just turned into the Avengers? I'm sorry, he's got a gun? Well, I guess in Tekken, like, some characters had guns, right? Like, they had handguns or some shit. Oh my god. Okay, I'm here for the story. The story seems interesting, especially from the background lore. Figured out about. It seems like it could be actually like really cool. Like son wanted to kill
dad. I remember they dropped that trailer and a bunch of white people were talking about some what happened to our beautiful game.
Wait, why? Cause the music? Peep this. Did you just send me a fucking meme? I've already seen this. That's old, by the way. Wait, why though? Like, what are they mad about? I don't know. People are just racist, man. People are just racist, man. Indiana Jones and the Great Circle. Gameplay, I guess. I didn't even know they were making a game. I'm not gonna lie. Why are we getting an Indiana Jones game and not a Mission Impossible game, bro? This is pissing me off, bro. Xbox Direct? What? Chat, what should I get the snack on? What snack should I get, chat? Sorry, made my decision. Already made my decision, man. I can't
not have it. I'm sorry.
I can't not have it, man. I'm addicted to these things, bro. I'm addicted to donut sticks, man. This shit's fucking hit, man. All right, let's see. Let's see what Xbox is cooking up, man.
You are missing, Dr. Jones. While you were playing your pointless game, I was playing you.
Y'all want to be Uncharted so damn bad, bro. I'm not gonna lie. It is kind of cringe. All right, no, let's actually see.
You're wondering if maybe you should have built yourself a life of meaning instead of ending up here, dead and forgotten in the sense of Africa.
It is given Uncharted, but obviously Uncharted is inspired from the movies.
Myths. History.
I'm sorry, is this in first person? That they lost it already.
Just different ways to interpret the past.
Just like that, I'm already out.
Thousands of years of humanity's thoughts and beliefs.
Bro, they had one job, bro. They had one job, man.
To be found.
You can't just run away from your problems, Indiana.
Watch me.
Bro. Who wants to do Indiana Jones like action gameplay in first person, man? I want to see all the shit, man. Bro, they just suck.
Throughout history, mankind has built sites of great spiritual significance. If you were to draw a line through these ancient sites around the globe, you get a perfectly aligned circle.
Ah! So you have moments for certain things that go in third person, but it's only for certain movement. Like, you should. Oh. I don't get it. I don't understand. Maybe it's an option.
I've had run-ins with these guys before. Trust me.
I know we just reacting to trailers, but hear this Eminem cover or somewhat cover. And by the way, it's only playable on Xbox and PC.
So it's, I hate when people say only playable on, like, you can't only playable on two things, bro. It's playable. Like, I could just play it, bro. Like, it's like you're trying too hard, man. You're trying too hard, man. It ain't only play, like, it's playable, bro. The only time you use the word only is when you're talking about PlayStation 5 exclusive. A PlayStation 5 exclusive. You can only play it on PlayStation. You can only play it on the Switch, bro. You can't only play it on Xbox console and like, bro, that's just, you could play it on PC.
It ain't a walk in the park.
Okay, then. Let's see if you can keep up.
What do you mean if I could keep up?
Yeah, think of how much cooler that would have been in first per- in third person.
Patron of the fallen angels. Protector of the...
They blew it, bro.
Chukulimani.
They blew it, man.
The Great Circle. You have any idea how old that was?
That was like a cute plane thing, bro. That was a cute plane thing. He jumped across the plane. You want to see how that shit's really done, okay? You want to see how a plane scene is really done in a game? Speak to my man, Nathan Drake.
My Steam Deck is coming tomorrow. What's your favorite games to play on it?
Bro. Hold on. Let me tell you what I have been playing on my Steam Deck, bro. The games I've been playing on my Steam Deck, man. Okay, so, Midnight Suns is, I have like 150 like 7 hours in Midnight Suns. It's actually disgusting. But there's this game here called Octopath, it's a vibe, trust, it's a vibe. I'm playing that one right now. That's like the newest thing that I'm playing. Also, Trials of Mana. Trials of Mana is a banger. I played and beat this. This is a vibe too. Hold on. If I could, there we go. This is a vibe too. I'm not gonna lie. Any Square Enix, like Square Enix type of game is just a vibe. But yeah, this is fire. I played and beat this. What else? Dragon Quest. I played and beat this. This is a vibe. This is absolutely amazing. I had so much fun with this. This was my shit. This is what, like, the, you know, that's what the game looks like. It's fire. I've been playing, there was another game. Where's it at? This game, this is called, I don't know what it's called, but it's fun. And, this shit's not in English though. So, you know, these niggas just be talking, but I don't care. Cause I just be swinging my sword and killing people. Cause this shit's lit. This is a lot of fun to play. Music is beautiful, things like that. So I mean, you see the type of games that I play. It's usually those type of games, bro. Bandai Namco or whatever the fuck, bro. A lot of the games that they make, those are the games that I'd be playing on my Steam Deck, because it's just like, it's just fun, and it's just an adventure, bro. The music be so beautiful in these worlds and shit like that. There's more games, but it's like mixed with all the other games that I buy on here. But yeah, it's basically those type those types of games, man. Just adventure, JRPG, RPG games, man. Those shits be bangers, bro. Them shits be bangers, man. Oh yeah, back to the best plane thing in the game. Absolutely amazing. I remember when I played this for the first time. Oh my god. I wish I could play this game. I wish I could play all these games again for the first time, bro. Look at this crunch. Oh my god, I remember when that trailer. Hold on. I remember when the trailer dropped for this and that shit will. Nathan Drake, the motherfucking goat, man. There we go. Hold on. Let's get to the best part, bro. Look at this. It's giving Tom Cruise. It's giving Tom Cruise, man. Look at this. Boom. Imagine how much is missed playing this shit in first person. All right, now watch this shit. Watch this fucking shit right here, bro. Watch this shit right here, man. I mean, playing this shit for the first time is like jaw-dropping. Jaw-dropping, bro. Hold on. Oh my god, here we go. Run, Nathan!
You hear about Until Dawn getting a movie?
Bro! Like, take a second to feel that chat. Oh my god. Take a second to feel that shit, bro. Yo, Crispy with the 5, get the subs. I appreciate you, bro. The side of the plane rips open, breaks open. You get sucked out of the plane, bro, into silence. Nothing but the air around you. And then you pan around. Yeah, the fucking plane is nosediving. Whoever thought of this, like, these sets on these games, bro, like, they need a fucking pay raise, bro. Holy shit. They was locked the fuck in. Okay, so we're gonna have them get sucked out the plane, right? And then we're gonna have silence, and then we're gonna have them turn around, and then we're gonna have the plane go. And that's not even the best part, bro. We're gonna have them. Hold on. Well done. Well done. What a game. They snap with this, bro.
Oh, thank God.
Holy shit, man. Okay, what'd you say, buddy? Sorry, I missed it. Crispy with another Wait, hold on. Is this two different Crispies? Like, did you just change your profile picture and gift another 5 subs? I would agree it's giving Tom Cruise, except Uncharted 3 dropped in 2011 and Mission Impossible Rogue Nation came out in 2015. So TC is giving Uncharted Nathan Drake the GOAT. Yeah. What? I'm talking about just the action, man. Come on, man. Come on, dude. All right. We got a game, another trailer for a game here. Manor Lords? I'm not sure what this is. Oh yeah, no thank you, sorry. No thank you, I'm out. Alone in the Dark.
Have you found anything strange going on here?
Oh, that's the actor.
Yes. Uncle?
Welcome to Dorcito. So that's that. Despacito.
Yeah. You think it'll actually come to that?
Welcome to Dorcito, detective. Now, what can I do for you?
Everyone is being incredibly evasive, and I can't figure out why.
I mean, something you can't explain. Paranormal, even.
Detective, I really need you to get yourself together. I can't do...
Wait, I just remember. Somebody said that Until Dawn is getting a movie. Yeah, they're gonna butcher that.
This alone.
Emily's here.
The doctor may be all about science, but I know these roots have power. Who are you? What are you doing here?
I'm get back
sure
to the goddamn
you have
fit.
A whole file on me by now, detective.
Who is it? Can it be trusted?
There is just something about tonight. Different.
Uncle, what's going on here? Look at this mess!
I'm sorry. This place? It's... There are some very disturbed figures around here. And I don't think it's just the patients. I've been reading some things about how Dorcito has a deranging effect on people.
What is this, chat?
Are you ready to tell me why you are here, Miss Hartwood? And why you brought a detective? I want you to know I'm here to help. If you need me.
She'll come and turn the world inside out.
Yo.
And things will begin again.
Knock her little ass out, bro. I hate little weird ass, stupid ass kids like that, bro. Like, what? What the hell is this? What is Elder Scrolls? Oh, Skyrim? Oh, shit. I never got into Skyrim. It was in my, like, vibe. You know? Chat, it's hard for me to get into, like, first-person, like, games. Especially when they take place in certain eras. Like, it's always been an absolute pet peeve of mine is when you can do heavy customization on a character just for the game to be in first person the whole time. I think it's the stupidest thing ever. I'm gonna try Pokemon with guns. No, I have played Bioshock. I have played Bioshock, but Bioshock doesn't take place in a time where it was like swords and shit like that. It's like, the thing about Bioshock, it was just like the world seemed interesting. So if a world seemed interesting enough, I'm gonna try it out. That's the only reason why I tried that one game. Remember with the robots? It was like the newer game. It was first person. It was like with robots or whatever. It was kind of like how Bioshock was. I forgot. Yeah, Atomic, whatever it was called. Atomic Heart was interesting. I like that one. Cyberpunk was fire too, because the world seemed interesting. And plus, Keanu Reeves was in that shit. That game was good. And there was like sex scenes and shit. That game was fire. Oh, let me look up. Power. Wait, is Power World single player? No way it's co-op. How are people playing this? Oh, early access. It's not what we thought.
Johnny Depp was
Sorry. I'm sorry, Elden Scrolls. I'm paying attention. Sorry, bro. Is Mike in here? Is Malicious Mike in here? I feel like this is the type of game. This is the type of shit you be into, man. I can't, like, I don't know, man. I don't know, man. This isn't how the game looks. Oh my God, you son of a bitch. I swear. Hold on. Elden Scrolls gameplay.
Hello, everyone. Robert Rambles here, and...
Yeah, you about to ramble, bro. I don't want to hear it. Got your ass.
For it all.
And da-da-da-da-da. Da-da-da-da-da. This is a lot. So this is the type of game where it's like just... You just... A lot to do, bro. Okay. Hold on. Let me look at the... Wait, I had it pulled up. Where's the PAL thing? Oh, God. Did I just exit out of it? That looked like the interesting video. Oh, no. It's right here. Okay. PAL World review.
Probably seen the crazy clips or trailers out there for PAL World, a vibrant-looking open-world survival game.
So it's like PvP
collecting, base building, battling, production lines of PALs manufacturing items, and, well, of course, the weapons. It's no surprise the game is sort of being memed on as Pokemon but with guns in various comments out there online, but well, it really isn't that. Or at least not just that. And a big thanks to Pocket Pair for providing us with an early copy of the game, so I've managed to play it, sink my teeth into it, and get an...
Oh my god, you can customize?
Providing us with an early...
Wait, chat, when does it drop?
...copy of the game, so I've managed...
It's a slavery game? I'm not gonna lie, those pals or whatever... They look miserable, bro. Like, that's like you clock into work and clock out and you just hate the next day, bro.
To play it, sink my teeth into it, and get an
I already know how my character gonna look.
...understanding of what it's about so I can share my impressions of the game with you guys. I'm gonna try and be fair and honest with my opinion on the game as a standalone thing, rather than comparing it directly to something like...
Chef Coco. Question, if you were born in the early 2000s, please answer so the music or at least the biggest hits from a single year came from 2012. Am I right or wrong? 2012 was the biggest and best year for music all around from 2000 up to now.
Wait, okay, hold on. There was a lot of numbers that just happened. Okay, let me read this and try to understand. Wait, chat, question. If you were born in the early 2000s, please answer. So the music, or at least the biggest hits from a single year, came from 2012. Am I right or wrong? 2012 was the biggest year for music all around. 2012? I'm not gonna lie.
Hold
I feel
on,
like...
Hold on, are we jumping armored? Give us a minute.
What's happening? I've seen that in the chat. Who is that getting, like, banned? I feel like... Wait, Demir's crying. Oh my gosh. I have fatherly instincts. He wasn't even crying. Wait, those are bad instincts then. I feel like, and maybe this is me kind of being like biased because this is where like it was like the really pinnacle of like my hip hop shit, of my hip hop reviewing shit. Wait, I feel like I can speak on this. I feel like I can speak on this because literally I was in this era. Like 2016, 17, 18, like I feel like 2000, between like 15 and 17 was when shit was going crazy, specifically like 16, 17, bro. That's personally to me, bro. Personally to me, because that's when everything was dropping, bro. Everything was dropping. Everything was going crazy. It was crazy, chat. I'm telling you, like, if I go to my YouTube page and go between those 3 years, oh my gosh, everything was up.
On because
like everything that dropped was just bangers, and it was just maybe you like more for the underground, like to for the under. So maybe it's different, bro. It depends on which music you're listening to, you know.
As you'll find out soon enough, it really is something else entirely. I'll start things off with my comments on its performance, because this can be a massive deal breaker for me, and I'm sure many of you guys, especially with it being early access. Mm-hmm. Honestly, this is one of those rare games that while it is in early access, it runs extremely smoothly, with my experience having none or very little performance issues.
So this is like a Fortnite early access thing.
Now I do have a
very- Where they're just in early access? For eternity.
A high-end PC with an RTX 4080, but I get a consistent 120 FPS while exploring, and the biggest drop that I've...
Sorry, why is he just hitting chickens?
...had so far was down to around 70 FPS while in a menu, which, as long as it stays above 60, is very good in my opinion, and certainly rare for an early access game. Now, the graphics definitely aren't groundbreaking, but it is stylized and it's enjoyable to look at for a prolonged gaming session, but I do wish there was more animations for things such as picking up resources, trees falling down after chopping them, or just visual representations of items like the PAL harnesses that you can craft.
I want that one.
Whatever years Lil Wayne was popping off was the best years. Haven't seen a year like those.
I mean, if we, like, it just, like, depends on what we talking about, because, like, Lil Wayne run was
2016
disgusting.
Was its best, but 2012 for sure was the best for music all around, from rap, pop, EDM, R&B, all that shit was bangers. Don't I just look it up for 2012 and 2016?
You covering everything, but then it's like we could also go to like early. We could also go to when like Usher was dropping, bro. When like Confessions was out, and then TLC was dropping shit, and their shit was on the radio. And then
Donald Taylor, hey Pookie Wookie Bear, my cutie patootie, my sugar daddy, my chocolate king, have you seen this game? It's a really, really short game that you can play today. Also, you look extra juicy, like Nando's hot meal with two sides.
All right, Buckshot Roulette. I think JoJo was talking about this game, but played it.
Instead, you just grab them, and there's no visible harness, even though you have to craft.
I need this one. I want a really powerful fire Palimon.
Or you can use them in this way. So overall, the performance is very good and the graphics are just all right. It feels polished in terms of its FPS, but everything
else does... It's a fucking flamethrower.
...feel very early access-y, with missing animations, odd cutscenes, and some jank in the combat and gameplay. But let me say, if you have a Steam Deck, this game is actually very easy to play on it. It's basically pick up and play. I downloaded it on my Steam Deck just for fun to see if it would work, and I found myself really enjoying it as a handheld experience.
Oh, say less. The grinding's gonna be insane then. Holy shit. The grinding's gonna be insane.
Again, the performance was very good on Steam Deck, so that did kind of shock me. So with some technical talk out of the way, let's
go crazy then.
Power World actually is, because my expectations were...
Also, to the guy that was asking, like, what games to play... Bro, look at this. Hold on. Wait, what the... God damn! Oh, yeah, see, I wouldn't be doing this. Like, I can't sit down and just do this at a, like... I could do this on my Steam Deck. Like, fuck around and, like, build shit and just chill and make stuff. But I can't do that on, like, just on a regular basis. Like, sitting down here on stream.
Definitely way off compared to what the game actually is. If you're expecting this to be a creature collecting game, where you simply go out, collect some monsters, train them up to get stronger and stronger with battling, to then take on bigger and better creatures as you expand out your party, well, it's not really that, or at least that's only a portion of what it is.
And that's what I thought it was.
It's not the full focus.
So then what are we playing, bro?
This is really unlike any other creature collecting game that I've played before, and it really threw me off to begin with. Initially, I was ready to go out and collect some pals, battle them together, and level up. When in reality, the game is actually more so a survival game, and so the survival game mechanics and gameplay systems that you would expect come first and foremost. This means the first hour...
Oh, no. Nah, man. Have me in the first half, bro. Bro, I'm sick of survival games, man. I feel like that's just like, oh my, I don't know. Whatever, bro. Because, like, even Lego Fortnite was cool just because I like Legos and I thought it would be cool. But it's like, bro, I don't really want to. I hate having to go to the woods and, like, collect shit and then, like, shit get cold. And then you got to, you know, get out the cold and da-da-da-da.
Hours of gameplay won't be just collecting and fighting your creatures to level them up. It will be picking up rocks and wood, building crafting stations to make tools, to then chop down trees and mine rocks, to then build up more and more resources so that you can actually build a base. At the beginning of the game, the creatures in the starting areas are a lot more smaller and basic. They're called pals in this game, by the way, so we'll refer to the creatures as pals from now on. You can just walk up to the pals and start punching them or attacking them with a weapon like a club that you can craft early on. And if you completely off them, then you get some resources and items and even meat that you can cook, because you will have to manage a hunger bar on yourself and your pals in your party. Oddly enough, when defeated, the dead body kind of ragdolls, making for some, well, very interesting interactions, which is not something I thought I would see in a creature collecting game. Of course, you're meant to get their health low so that you can capture them with the pal spears that you can find or craft, which again feeds into the heavy need for resources just like any other survival game. So after a few hours of farming, building up and
hard enough to survive in real life, now niggas want me to do it in a game for fun. Man, fuck you all.
It's just like, how many times do we have to start from nothing and then grind up? I feel like by the time, every time I play like these survival type games, I get to the point where I finally make like a good house or have a good base, and then I don't play it ever again. It's the same thing when me and all of some bros played that whatever forest game it was, where we were in the forest and you got to collect shit. We all play that shit until we build up a base, we got a nice base and we got shit set, and we're like, yo, we got a nice base, and then we never play the game again. I feel like this always happens. Oh my god. Whatever, man. I really thought it was going to be like just fighting. I thought like you collect, you fight, you win. Collect, you fight, you win. All right.